Hello friends, today's topic of discussion is phosphorus, magnesium and sulfur. These are major elements. Minerals, they are divided into two main types, major elements and minor elements. Major elements means when the requirement is more than 100 mg per day, they are known as major elements. It includes mainly calcium, phosphorus, magnesium, sulfur, sodium, potassium, chloride. While in minor element, when the requirement is less than 100 mg per day, they are known as minor element or trace element, which principally involves the iron, copper, zinc, iodine, fluorine, etc. Okay. Now coming to the description of phosphorus, magnesium and sulfur. Of these, phosphorus is an important short answer question. Short answer question, phosphorus. Okay. Or you may get BAQ on the biochemical functions of magnesium or biochemical functions of sulfur. So we'll discuss phosphorus, magnesium and sulfur under the heading of RDA, recommended dietary allowance, sources, functions and deficiency manifestations. So we'll discuss under these four headings. Okay. Now coming to the phosphorus, so total body content is near about 1 kg. Of this, 80% it is found in bones and teeth along with calcium. It is found in bones and teeth, 10% in muscle and RBCs. And remaining 10% in various compounds. Okay. Now, what is RDA of phosphorus? It is near about 800 milligram per day. And what are the sources? The important dietary source of phosphorus is milk. Milk and milk products, then meat, eggs, cereals, and vegetables. These are the important sources for phosphorus. Now coming to the biochemical functions, you may get brief answer question, 2 mark question on biochemical functions of phosphorus. So what are the biochemical functions of phosphorus? The important function of phosphorus is, it is required for the synthesis of various compounds, which mainly includes, so phosphorus, it is required for the synthesis of nucleoproteins. Which mainly includes DNA and RNA. So nucleotides, these are building blocks for the DNA and RNA. Nucleotides, they are made up of sugar, nitrogen base and phosphate. Okay. So polymerization of nucleotide in DNA and RNA, it occurs with the help of formation of 3' 5' 5' phosphodiester linkage. So it is important in the synthesis of nucleoproteins. Also it is important in the synthesis of phospholipids. Examples are lecithin, sepaline, phosphatidine, inositol, cardiolipins. These are the examples of phospholipids. Then it is also important in the synthesis of phosphoprotein. Example is casein. So it is important in the synthesis of nucleoproteins, phospholipid, phosphoproteins. Then it is important in the enzyme regulation and activation of enzyme regulation by the covalent modification in the enzyme. The major covalent modification in the enzymes, they are activated by phosphorylation and dephosphorylation reactions. Some enzymes, they are active in the phosphorylated state, for example, glycogen phosphorylase, and some enzymes, they are active in the dephosphorylated state, for example, glycogen synthase. So it is important in the phosphorylation reaction. So it is enzyme regulation, that is phosphorylation reaction. Then they are important for synthesis of high energy compounds. High energy compounds. The main compounds are ATP, GTP, then creatine phosphate, etc. These are the high energy compounds. So for the synthesis of high energy compound, phosphate is required. Then phosphate is a major intracellular buffer, and it is important in the acid base balance, mainly intracellularly. At pH 7.4, it is present in the ratio of 4:1, disodium acid phosphate and sodium dihydrogen phosphate, it is present in the ratio of 4:1 at pH 7.4. So it is important intracellular buffer, phosphate. Okay. Then again, it is required for the synthesis of various coenzymes. It is required for the synthesis of various coenzymes. For example, pyridoxine, the coenzyme form is pyridoxal phosphate. Thiamine, the coenzyme form of thiamine is thiamine pyrophosphate. Then phosphate, it is also present in coenzyme A. It is present in NADP. So these are the coenzyme forms. So phosphate, it is important in the synthesis of coenzyme forms of various vitamins. The intracellular concentration of phosphate is near about 3 to 4 milligram per day. Sorry, per deciliter. 3 to 4 milligram per deciliter serum concentration. And in blood, it is near about 30 to 40 milligram per deciliter in blood because of content in RBCs and WBCs. RBCs and WBCs having more phosphorus, that's why the content in blood is more, 40 milligram per deciliter, but in serum it is 3 to 4 milligram per deciliter. Got it? So these are the functions of phosphorus, but the main important function of phosphorus is, it is important in the formation of bones and teeth. Formation of bone and teeth along with the calcium. It is important in the formation of bones and teeth. So these three hormones along with the calcium, they also regulate the phosphorus level. Parathyroid hormone, vitamin D, that is calcitriol, and calcitonin. These also regulates the phosphorus level. So vitamin D increases the absorption of phosphorus, while parathyroid hormone decreases the absorption. Okay, so this is the serum phosphorus level, 3 to 4 milligram per deciliter. These are the important functions of phosphorus. Bone and teeth formation, important constituent in DNA and RNA, phospholipid formation, phosphoprotein, casein, enzyme regulation, enzyme activation by phosphorylation and dephosphorylation, that is known as covalent modification in the enzymes. Formation of high energy compounds, ATP, GTP, creatine, they act as an intracellular buffer. It is a major intracellular buffer. The disodium hydrogen acid phosphate and sodium dihydrogen phosphate, it is present in concentration of 4:1 at pH 7.4. It is a most potent buffer present intracellularly. Then they are important in the synthesis of coenzyme PLP, thiamine pyrophosphate, coenzyme NADP, etc. The main these hormones which regulate the calcium level also regulates the phosphorus level, mainly the calcitriol, which increases the absorption. Then parathyroid and calcitonin also regulate the serum phosphorus level. Now, what are the deficiency manifestations? Mainly the deficiency manifestations they are very less or very rare. Deficiency manifestations, they are very rare because in this phosphorus is present in every cell. So dietary deficiency of phosphate is very rare. The decrease in the phosphorus, it is known as hypophosphatemia. Hypophosphatemia. It is mainly due to malabsorption, malnutrition. Malnutrition due to decrease intake or decrease absorption. Then vitamin D deficiency, that is mainly rickets, and hyperparathyroidism. In this condition, there is decrease in the phosphate level. While increase in the phosphate level, it is mainly found in hypoparathyroidism, then vitamin D toxicity, and it is in cancer chemotherapy, secondary is in bone. In this condition, there is increase in the phosphate level occurs. But these are the important condition, disease manifestation, hypophosphatemia. Increase, it is known as hyperphosphatemia. Okay. So these are the disease conditions related with the phosphorus. Now coming to the discussion of next mineral, that is magnesium. So we'll discuss this topic, magnesium, in very, very short. In the magnesium, it is the total body content of magnesium is near about 20 gram. Of this, 70% it is mainly present in bones and 30% it is present in soft tissues and fluids. Okay. RDA of magnesium is 350 milligram in case of males and 300 milligram in females. And sources are mainly vegetables, then milk, meat, and cereals. These are the sources for magnesium. Now, important biochemical function of magnesium is it is required for the formation of bones and teeth with calcium and phosphorus. Second important function, it is required for the activation of various enzymes which requires ATP. These enzymes mainly are glucokinase, hexokinase, phosphofructokinase, then adenylate cyclase. These are the enzymes required, magnesium as a cofactor. Okay. And third important, it is required for neuromuscular function. It is required for neuromuscular function. So these are the three important functions of magnesium. In deficiency, there is neuromuscular irritability. When there is deficiency of magnesium, neuromuscular irritability, convulsion, these are the manifestations. So manifestations are mostly similar with the tetany, which is occur mainly with due to the deficiency of calcium. So it is similar to that of the tetany, that is neuromuscular spasm, neuromuscular irritation, convulsion, and it is relieved by giving the magnesium. Okay, so this is all about the magnesium in short. Now coming to the discussion of sulfur. Sulfur, it is a major element. The requirement as such is not known. It is required because it is present in almost all proteins. The proteins which contain amino acids means methionine, cysteine, cysteine, they also contain the sulfur. That's why RDA of sulfur is not known. It is present in all protein. The sources are dietary proteins, and the biochemical functions, important biochemical functions of sulfur are sulfur, it is present in sulfur containing amino acids. So it is a constituent biochemical functions of sulfur. It is a constituent of sulfur containing amino acid, that is cysteine, cysteine and methionine. So it is important in the protein synthesis. It is important in the orientation of polypeptide because it is responsible for formation of disulfide linkage, and also it is important in the formation of sulfidyl group. So it is important in protein orientation. So it is important in the protein synthesis, sulfur. Okay, so these are the sulfur containing amino acids, and the protein which having these amino acids are the good sources for the sulfur. There are some vitamins which contain sulfur. This includes thiamine, biotin, lipoic acid and coenzyme A. These are the some vitamins which contains sulfur. There are some compounds, for example glutathione, then some glycosaminoglycans, for example chondroitin sulfate heparin. So heparin, chondroitin sulfate, and some bile acid, for example taurocholate. These are the compounds which contain sulfur. Then PAPS, that is phosphoadenosine phosphosulfate. It is an important sulfur donor and important in the synthesis of glycosaminoglycans, mucopolysaccharides. It is important in the synthesis of mucopolysaccharide. Also, it is important in the detoxification reactions. Then the sulfur, it is required for the transmethylation reactions means transfer of methyl group, methylation reaction. The number of products they are formed by the transmethylation reaction. So it is important in the transmethylation reaction. The deficiency manifestation of sulfur is not important. It is not common. So we will not discuss the deficiency manifestation. You may get BAQ on magnesium and sulfur. It is not important for SAQ, short answer question. The phosphorus, it is important for SAQ. Got it? So biochemical function of magnesium and sulfur, these are the BAQ, 2 marks question about the functions of magnesium and sulfur. Got it? So this is all about phosphorus, magnesium and sulfur. So keep watching. Thank you.